In this module, we will learn about the properties of whole numbers. Now, we will learn addition of whole numbers and closure and commutative property for the addition of whole numbers. First of all, let us take addition of whole numbers. Adding two whole numbers, 2 plus 3 is equal to 5, 3 plus 3 is equal to 6, and 0 plus 8 is equal to 8. What did you observe? 0 plus 8 is equal to 8. The sum is always a whole number. And this is what the closure property states. Closure property of addition states that when we add two whole numbers, the sum is always a whole number. Now we will study about the commutative property of addition. 3 plus 2 is equal to 2 plus 3. The sum in both the cases is 5. Whether we add 2 apples to 3 apples or we add 3 apples to 2 apples, the sum will always be equal to 5 apples. This is what the commutative property states. In general, we can say that A plus B equals to B plus A. That is, the order in which you add does not matter at all. The sum will always be the same. You will be amazed to know that this is true for multiplication as well. Now we will learn multiplication of whole numbers and the closure and commutative property for it. Multiplying two whole numbers, 2 into 3. Everybody knows it is equal to 6. 4 into 2 is equal to 8. Now, what did you observe? That 2 into 3 is equal to 6 is a whole number, and 4 into 2 is equal to 8, again a whole number. So the product is always a whole number. So you observe that the closure property for multiplication of whole numbers state that the product of two whole numbers is always a whole number. Now we will see whether the commutative property also holds for multiplication or not. This we will check with an example. Suppose Raman find the product of 4 and 2. 4 into 2 is equal to 8. And Rita find the product as 2 into 4. 2 into 4 is equal to 8 again. So, what do you observe? That whether we multiply 4 by 2 or we multiply 2 by 4, the result will remain same, as 4 2's are 8 and 2 4's are 8. So, this is what is known as the commutative property of multiplication. When we multiply two whole numbers, the order of multiplication does not alter the product, and this is known as the commutative property of multiplication. I hope it is clear to you that the commutative property of multiplication means that 3 into 4 is equal to 12 and 4 into 3 is again equal to 12. The order of multiplication does not change the product. So we conclude that in the commutative property, the order of numbers does not change the answer of an addition problem or a multiplication problem. And in generalized form, we can say that A plus B equals to B plus A. For example, 2 plus 3 is equal to 3 plus 2. and a multiply by b is equal to b multiply by, so 2 into 3 is equal to 3 into 2. Both the product will be equal to 6. So once again I am repeating that in both addition and subtraction, the order of numbers does not change the answer of an addition problem or a multiplication problem.